Good morning. Today we are going to determine the minimum angular speed to spin a bucket in a vertical circle such that water will stay in the bucket.
Flippin' physics.
Didn't we do this already?
Yep. Twice.
Actually, no. We have determined why water stays in the bucket and analyzed the situation generally. However, we have not solved this particular problem. Billy, could you please read the problem? And Bobby, could you please translate?
What is the minimum angular speed necessary to keep water in a vertically revolving bucket? The rope radius is 0.77 meters.
Minimum angular speed equals ? And radius equals 0.77 meters.
Bo, please solve the problem.
I got nothing.
Don't look at me.
We need to draw a free body diagram.
Sure, but where do we pause the bucket to draw the free body diagram?
Okay, let's start by spinning the bucket and slowing the angular speed down to the moment where water just barely starts to flow out of the bucket. You can see that's right where we're talking about.
Bobby, where is the bucket physically located when water just starts to flow out of the bucket?
Well, it looks like water starts to flow out of the bucket when the bucket is near the top of the circle.
That is correct. Realize water is most likely to flow out of the bucket when the bucket is at the top of the circle. So, Bo, please draw a free body diagram of all the forces acting on the bucket when the bucket is at the top of the circle.
Force of gravity is down, and the force of tension is also down.
Bo, please continue to solve the problem.
Because the bucket is moving in a circle, let's sum the forces in the in direction. So the net force in the in direction equals force of gravity plus force of tension.
It looks like both of those forces are down. Shouldn't both of those forces be negative?
No. The force of gravity and the force of tension are both positive because they are both in toward the center of the circle, and the in direction is always positive. The inward net force also equals mass times centripetal acceleration. Force of gravity equals mass times acceleration due to gravity. And centripetal acceleration equals radius times angular velocity squared. However, we don't know the force of tension, so we don't have enough here to solve for the angular velocity.
Bless you.
That is correct so far. Now, in a previous lesson, we showed why water stays in the bucket by comparing the water in the bucket to water coming out of a horizontally oriented hose. There were two conditions we talked about. One where the water from the hose is moving quickly enough such that it would stay in the bucket, and one where water from the hose is moving too slowly such that it would not stay in the bucket. It turns out there is also another possibility. The water could be moving at the minimum speed necessary to barely stay in the bucket. When this happens, the radius of curvature of the arc of projectile motion of the water coming from the horizontally oriented hose matches the radius of the circle through which the bucket is moving. Watch carefully to what happens when I slow the angular speed of the bucket down to the point where water just starts to flow out of the bucket. What happens to the rope at this point?
Yeah, the rope goes slack.
Right, the force of tension in the rope is zero at the minimum angular velocity for water to stay in the bucket.
That is because at the top of the bucket's path, the bucket no longer needs to pull the water in towards the center of the circle because the radius of the curvature of the arc of projectile motion of the water in the bucket perfectly matches the radius of the circle through which the bucket is moving.
Makes sense. As the angular velocity decreases, the force of tension decreases and reaches zero at that minimum angular velocity.
Then we just plug in zero for the force of tension and everybody brought mass to the party.
Yep. Everybody brought mass.
And we can solve for the angular velocity. It equals the square root of the acceleration due to gravity divided by radius, or the square root of 9.81 divided by 0.77, which equals 3.5694, or 3.6 radians per second with two significant digits. That is the minimum angular speed we can spin the bucket at and have water not flow out of the bucket. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you. I would like to take a moment to clarify the variable r, the radius in this problem. I referred to it as the rope radius, which is not quite correct. R is the radius of the circle, which means it is the distance from the center of the circle to the center of mass of the bucket water system, which clearly is a bit longer than the length of the rope, but it is the 0.77 meters which I measured. Sorry to lead you astray a bit.